So the first lab program that we have is write an HTML program to display the following table. The day they have given, today, tomorrow, Monday, and then they have given the condition, temperature, wind. So a few of the students have tried and they have sent me the program. So I want you to give a try. Have you all tried this, or you want me to explain this? I want your responses. And they have told you to use the cell spacing, align, and cell padding attributes you have to use. Or can somebody tell me what should be the program voluntarily so that I can start writing it? Can you all try this, or you have tried it? So I will take a new file and then I will save this as. So we'll save this file. So I require HTML. Then I will say head tag I will use inside this title. Give this file. So give the name of the file as lab1.html. lab_1.html. So then I will say term work. And then simultaneously we can start writing this program. Okay. Then followed by this, what I should do? Put the heading tag. Then what will come? Which tag I have to open? Meanwhile, I will close the HTML tag as well. After this, which tag I have to use? I want responses from other students. Vishal, can you tell me?
Sir, body.
Body tag, okay, fine. So meanwhile, I will close this body tag as well. So this is how you have to write so that you can avoid the errors. The moment you open the tags, with that, if there is any closing tag or pair of the tags, you have to close it. Then what is required? I have to open the table. So I will open a table tag. Okay. And followed by this, I want to give some border for it because they have mentioned the border here. If you look into this, there is a border for that table. So I will keep the border as say border equal to 5. And these attributes values you have to specify in double quotes. Then they also told you to use cell padding and cell spacing. Okay, you have to use cell spacing and cell padding. So what I will do, I will take the, after this, I will take cell padding. So say cell padding is equal to say 4. And then I will say cell spacing equal to say 3. So what is cell padding and cell spacing? If you remember, I will also close the table. Okay. Then what I have to do? How many rows I have to create? If a caption is required, you can do it. Otherwise, you can skip this caption. We require 4 rows. So what I have to do? So I will create 4 TRs first. TR close the tr tag. Same thing I will copy tr. Okay, so I have created four rows, and then the first one, what I have to do in first one, I require the column names. So column names, for column names, what we will prefer, we prefer it as row names or column names, we prefer it as th, that is the table headers. So I require th, I will create th. Okay, and here I will write day, the th tag, then just copy it. Then I will say today. Next, whatever is the information, I will mention it as tomorrow. And next, we will take it as Monday. Okay, so we have created the first row. So meanwhile, you can execute this program if you want. So we'll just change this to, what is the name I have given? I have given the name as lab1. So lab_1.html. So I created only this. Now what I have to do? I have to create the row names. Okay. So I will copy this again. Row names I have to create. Row names are like condition, and then we have the value as Sunny, and then we have the value as mostly Sunny, and then we have the value as partly Sunny. Is this correct? Look into the program. So only the first row name should be, here the second row name should be condition, then the value is Sunny, mostly Sunny, and partly cloudy. Okay, so we have to, instead of th, I have to use what I have to use. If you use th, all will appear in bold, but I do not want it as bold. I want this as the data. So I will use the tag as td tag. Are you all following? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So I will use td. Next, what I have to do, I have created another row. So we can run and check this, how it is working. So we have created this. The same thing I will copy now, because the first value should be the th. So I will copy this. And just for the explanation, I'm copying it, but you type it of your own. It will take more time, so I'm just taking it. So the second is what? Temperature. So we'll take the temperature. And the values are what? The values are 90 degrees Celsius and so on. So how to do that 90 degrees Celsius? 19 degrees Celsius. How to do it? Can somebody tell me? We have discussed this. And what we call them as?
HTML entities.
Yes. Only entities or character entities? So I want 90 degrees Celsius. 90 degrees Celsius. So I will use 90% DEG okay, semicolon C. Okay, so just check the information. Yes, we are getting it correctly. So similar to this, we'll say ampersand DEG, then semicolon C, and then 12 ampersand DEG semicolon C. Okay. Fine. And then this last one. Again, I require this. Just for the explanation purpose, I'm using it, but you do not do this. Do it. Then what are the values? So wind. Then the values that we have. 13 kilometer per hour. Okay, then we can say 12 kilometers or 11 kilometers, whatever the value we have that you specify. Okay, then this last one, 16 kilometers per, you can specify it. Fine. This can be sufficient. Okay, but the table is not having any name. So we have missed the caption. Okay, so where to give the caption? Where should I specify? We can give a, after this, we can use the option called as caption. And we can give the name as lab program or lab term work. Because they have not mentioned it, or you can just give a name as simple table. Close the caption. Any other information we need to add for this? And they have told we have used cell padding and cell spacing and alignment, they have told. So you can use the alignment for entire TR, or you can use the alignment for the individual values. Like for in this case, what is our output we are getting? So we can use different alignments. So for this values, like for second and this 90 degree 70 degree, you can use the alignment as center, and for this text value you can use the alignment as left alignment, and so on. So the values for this, we will use it as alignment as TR, or we will just look into how they have used the alignment. So this is the alignment. So here, if you observe, day, today, tomorrow and Monday, they are all center aligned. So by default, it will take the center alignment. Are you understanding this? Day, today, tomorrow and Monday, all are center aligned. Yes or no? Similarly, yes. Condition, temperature, wind, all are center aligned. So no need to make any changes for that. But whereas if you observe the sunny, mostly sunny and partly cloudy, how we are getting? So we are also getting the in the same way. And in this case, 90 degrees, 70 degrees Celsius, 12 degrees Celsius, we can make them as left alignment. Okay. So we can use the values or our own values. We can take it as alignment. So we can, for this also, we can mention the align. Align equal to center. This alignment property, we can use it for the td elements. And we can check the result. Are we getting it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Any other changes has to be made? Or if you want to give for, say, for example, this entire row, you can use the alignment. Okay. Can use for the TD values. Like how you can give the V alignment. I want to show that also in the same program. You can use the V alignment for these values. V align. So we have used cell padding, cell spacing, alignment, everything we have used. Fine. Or if you want to increase the cell spacing, we can keep it as cell spacing as 10 and cell padding as 5. Maybe 8 you can keep so that in this way also you can do it. So this is your first lab assignment. Are we clear with this, everyone? So in the examination, they may ask
yes,
you
sir.
To modify these. Okay, once you are done with this basic thing, they may ask you to align it left towards right or center or align this entire row. So you have to give the options or the alignment for this entire row. In that way, you have to be careful. Very simple program it is. So this ends the discussion of tables with the assignment as well. So I want you to practice and execute it. I hope everyone has written the programs in your notebook. I want responses from other students as well. Yes, is this clear? Program is clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So very simple program. And the same program can be asked in the theory exam as well. Explain the tables with an example. So you can write the same example. I mean, just these are simple tags. So it will not take hardly, not more than 5 minutes. So let's go ahead with the next concept. Very, very important concept of the HTML. That is the forms. So what are basically forms are all about? Why we require these forms? So basically see, whenever we want to register something, like for example, you want to fill the details. Like for example, if for your COVID registration, you may be giving your names, address and other information details, or if you're applying for any jobs and other details, and you want the information to be stored in the web server, or when we want to send the data to some databases. So in such situations, we use the concept of forms. So the most common way for user to communicate information from a web browser to the server is through the form. So like these are the basic building blocks that we have discussed, like the tables, lists and so on. But in a more efficient way, if you want to use the web application, it is all based on the forms. It may be like, for example, you may be purchasing some goods from the online web stores or like from Flipkart and so on. So you may be entering all the details and you want to submit the button. So the moment you submit the button, what will happen? Your information or your data will be passed from the web browser through the server, and it will be stored or it will be referred. And with that, you'll get the confirmation that your order is booked or you have been logged into the Gmail and so on. So these are the basically what we call it as the forms. And these forms consist of different kinds of objects, or the XHTML provides different elements inside the form. And these objects or the elements, we call them as the controls or the widgets. So what are the different types of controls or widgets that we have? So we can have the buttons, okay, or we can have the submit button or reset button. We can have the radio buttons. We can have the combo boxes and so on and forth. So forth, many different elements or the widgets that can appear in the form element. So basically the form tag, how it consists of. So this form tag is like a block tag, we can say, like we have the body tag. Okay. So whatever you want to mention, like a paragraph, list, table, and so on, you mention inside the body tag. Similarly, if you want to use all these widgets, like a text box or a label or a combo box and so on, all those should appear within this form tag. So the all the controls of a form appear in the content of the form tag. And then it is a block tag form that can have several different attributes, only one of which is action is required. So form tag can have different attributes, like for the TR and TD we have discussed, like alignment, V alignment and so on. Like this, there can be different attributes that can be present for the form. But one most important attribute that we have for the form is the action as the attribute. And this action attribute specifies the URL of the application on the web server that is to be called when the user clicks the submit. This action button will tell us, or this action button will actually have the information what will happen when you submit the button, where the information should reach. For that purpose, we use this action. So this action should be used. Like we said that the form tag can have different attributes, but the action attribute is the one which has to be used inside the form tag. But for our example, we'll be not specifying any URL or any information. We'll be just mentioning the action. For the action attribute, we are mentioning the value as the double quotes. Okay. So this means that we are not going to send any information. It will remain on the same page. Are we getting it? So basically this action button can have the values like get and post. So what are this get and post later on? But these are the attribute values that we will be using it to send the data with that particular URL, or with the browser we want to send some data. And the alternate value for the action can be post. So in both the techniques, we are going to take the data which is available in the form, and then we'll be sending it to the next URL or to the web server. So you can see a simple form HTML form example. So if I take this, you can see that there are a lot of different things that are present. Like you can see that there is, these all are called as the labels, like name, company, title, and so on. Here we can see that these are the text boxes. This is the select box. Here we can have the and we can have the passwords and so on. Here we can have the save button, cancel button. So a form can contain different objects, or we call them as the widgets. Like in this case, you can see that there are radio buttons are available. There are password boxes available and so on. So all these are used for different purposes. We can have also the like text area, like for example, if you want to type your message, or you can use the message box, or like for example, if you want to type your addresses, we can use this field and so on. So there are a lot of different fields that can be used inside the HTML form. Like for here in this case, you can see. We can use the calendar and many other information or many other widgets can be used inside the form. So what will happen inside this? So like for the simple form you have, and the moment you click on the submit button, so there will be a attribute called as the action. So whatever we have mentioned in the action, it will reach to that particular website or to the URL and your data will be stored. But in our example, we'll be not going into that. We'll be using only the simple ones. Are we getting it, everyone? What is the form tag? Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So basically, whenever we require the form, we want to provide some information. So for to provide the information, we require this input tag. So many of the commonly used controls are specified within the inline tag that we call as the input tag, including those for the text, text boxes like passwords, checkboxes, radio buttons, and so on. We use this input tag. So the first one among this we are going to study is about the text box. So let us see with a simple example program of a form. So I have not given any name for it. So how we have to use this? Okay, so this is the simple form. I will just save this. Okay, so this is how you have to use HTML head, title, body, and so on. And after this, you have to use this form tag. So inside the form, you have this attribute called as the action. And this values can be get, post, or it can be just double quotes. So double quote means that we are not going to send this information to any other server. It will remain on the same page itself. Later on, you'll get to know about this with some other examples. But for our studies, we'll be taking the input tag. So we want to write our name inside a text box. So to create the text box, what you have to do? You can leave this part now as of now label. So I will create this input type equal to text, a name equal to my name, size, and so on and so forth. So how it will appear? Let's run this program now. How it looks, you'll get to know about it. We can make this as demo_13.html. So this is the form that we have created, and here we call it as something called as the label. So like for example, what user should enter, whether he should enter his name, surname, address, and so on. So for that we can use the labels. So before we go and go ahead with that, you can skip this part. Labels you can remove and you can just keep the input tag. We will remove this label. That means if you do not specify the label with the label tag, only a text box will appear. So the user may not know what he should enter, whether he should enter his roll number or name and other things. So to give the proper meaning for the information that a user can provide, or it should help the user to provide a proper information, we use these labels. Like the first one, that is the text boxes. So whenever you want to give a text box, we have to use this. So this is the input tag. This type will specify whether it is a text box, whether it is a button, or whether it is a password box, and so on. So for that, what do you have to use? You have to use like this. Open this tag, input. Then you have to specify the attribute as type. It can have many attributes, but the basic thing is type equal to text. We want to have a text box. So that means the type equal to text, and then you can give the name equal to txt1. Or we can say txt2 because this is a text box 2. And then you can close this. This is also sufficient for the input tag. That is the for the text box. Are you getting it? But if I want to take it down, I can use a br tag. That I can go to the next. Are we following it? So, but if you want to restrict some size for it, so what you can use, you can specify the size. So what this size will indicate and what this size indicates and max length indicates, that is in this text box, if you observe, I will go on typing or I will just put another break line because I want some spaces here. Okay, I will use another one. So in this, I can type only this much, not more than this. Okay. Or I can say if you want typing numbers, only these many values you can type because we have mentioned it as max length as 20. But here, if I go on typing, it can take as many numbers as you want. And this depends on the browsers. Different browsers have different maximum length. So by using this size, you can specify what should be the size of the text box. And when we say max length 20, it cannot proceed. I mean, it cannot have the values more than 20. That is the meaning of size and max length. And these are also the attributes of the input tag. Are you all getting it? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Others? And what yes, this sir. Name is required? That means I can have here n number of input elements. I can have a text box, I can have a password box, yes. And so on. So to uniquely identify each text box, like in this case, I have two text boxes, text box one and text box two. I want to identify them uniquely. Okay, so individually, if you want to identify them, you can use the name attribute, or also there is an attribute called as ID, which will be always unique. So to give a name for the text boxes or to give the name for any elements in the form, we use this attribute called as name. Okay, so this will not actually appear on the text box. This is meant for the mentioning what should be the name of the that particular element or that particular input tag. Are you getting it? Or we can name this as txt1 because this is text box 1, this is text box 2. Are you getting it? But name values can be same. This can be text txt1, this can be also txt2. But usually whenever we use another attribute called as the ID, they will be always unique. So even if there are 10 text boxes or 10 password boxes and so on, we can uniquely identify them by using something called as the ID. When we study about JavaScript, you'll come to know about the advantage of having this, giving a unique name for these name and ID attributes. Are we clear with this first one? That is the input tag.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So like for example, if you want to give the phone number, so the max length you can give it as 10. So this is how we can restrict the values that a user can enter. So here, if I go on typing it, I'm just restricting it. So this is the first thing. And next one we can observe is, so that it is a type of input which takes the text. Any type of input can be created using input. The type attribute indicates what type of input is needed for the text box. The value should be given as text. For any type of input, a name has to be provided, which is done using the name attribute. The size of the text can be controlled using the size attribute. What should be the size? and every browser has a limit on number of characters it can collect. If this limit is exceeded, the extra characters are chopped off. So in the earlier case, when I go on writing different values, it will be discarded. So to prevent this chopping, max length attribute can be used. When max length is used, users can enter only those many characters that is given as a value to the attribute. So the next one, the simple one I will take, that is the password. If the contents of the text box should not be displayed when they are entered by the user, a password control can be used. In this case, regardless of what characters are typed into password control, only bullets or asterisks are displayed by the browser. Like to create a password box, what we can do, instead of this, I will change it as. So in this case, one more important thing, that is we are not able to identify which is the name, which is the password. So if I just make this as. For example, I will just change this. Okay, I will make this as input type equal to password. Okay, and name equal to my underscore password. Okay. And if I just run this, so you will not know where you have to enter your name and where you have to enter your password. Okay. So to make this user understand what we should enter, we will be using something called as the label. So label will give a name for those widgets. Like the name can be, so for to use this label, what we can use the tag called as label. Okay. And here we can specify it as enter your name. Okay, and inside this you have to write the input tag, and once you are finished with the input tag, you can close this label. Are we getting it? So here you will enter your name. And here this is created for the password. So similarly for this, I want to create a label. So I will say label, and what value I should specify. I want to enter my password. So label tag followed by enter your password. Then we'll have the input tag. And for this also, I can restrict the size of the password and so forth. And then I will close this label tag. Are you getting it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So the moment you enter in the password, what will happen? It will either appear in asterisks or bullets. Okay, so this is what we have in the forms. So we'll be studying different elements like a radio button, select tag and so on in the coming classes. Are we clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Are you following the subject?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. Start practicing these programs so that you'll come to know these, because in the exam they will be asking only these, explain input tag and forms and so on. So we'll be taking simple examples and you'll be explaining. All it is program part. There is no theory involved in this. So if you are if you get hands-on experience on these things, you can easily write it. The purpose of text box, what is the purpose, what is the purpose of password, and so on and so forth. Okay, fine. We'll end the session now. Thank you all.